Hello, namaste, welcome to Greet Taro. So how are you? I hope you're doing good. I hope you're having an amazing day today. So if you're new here, if you like my content, please support my channel. Or if you have already supported me, thank you so very much for all the love and the support, guys. It means a lot to me. Thank you so very much. So in the description box, I have my Instagram page link. If you want to follow me there, go ahead and give it a follow. And the decks that I'll be using in this reading will also be listed in the description box below. Okay, so today's pick card readings topic is next phase of your journey. Okay, so that is going to be the topic for today. Remember, these are general readings, so take what resonates and leave the rest behind, guys. And these are timeless readings also, so whenever you watch this reading, might have a message for you. Okay, so I have three decks for you guys. So I have kept three oracle cards. So I'll be using for group number one, I'll be using the mystical wisdom deck. Okay, so that is the group for group number one. It's mystical wisdom deck, and the crystal is rose quartz for group number one. Okay, for group number two we have the pirate crystal and sacred traveler oracle cards for group number two. And last but not the least, we have sodalite for group number three and wisdom of the oracle deck. Okay, so close your eyes, relax, take your time, and let go of all the worries, and then select a deck that calls to you intuitively. Group number one, group number two, and group number three. So the timestamps will be in the description box. I'm starting with group number one. Number one, if you have chosen this rose quartz crystal and this mystical wisdom oracle cards, let's see what is this next phase of your journey with this rose quartz. Make self-love a priority, make yourself a priority, make your dreams a priority, move towards your dreams, don't give up on your dreams. That's something I'm hearing. And you know, self-love is about taking action to fulfill your dreams, because the things that make you happy, that is what you need to do. It's all about self-love, right? Self-love is not only about taking care, lighting a candle. Yeah, it all includes here, taking that relaxing period. It's all about self-love. But I feel like doing something that you love, taking action to something that you want, you know, you want deeply. That is also self-love. I feel like doing something that you always wanted to do. Like maybe your childhood dream was to go camping. Maybe do that. Yeah, that's something I'm getting here. That's what you need to do in this next phase of your journey, I feel like, and I feel like you will be doing that. Maybe for you guys, your dreams were always on the side list, like you made other people's desires a priority rather than yours. Now what I see is in this next phase, you're making yourself a priority. Okay, so let's see group number one. What is this next phase of your journey, group number one? Pick your battles wisely. Yes. Okay, I feel like in this next phase of your journey, you are going to be with the people who you love, who you admire. You're not going to be with someone who don't value you. Yeah, I told you, you're going to make yourself a priority. You're not going to be arguing with someone who doesn't understand you. You're not going to be with someone who will not change. You're not going to you're not going to be with someone who don't appreciate you anymore. Maybe you had been in this kind of relationship where you were doing for other people. You were giving lot. You were giving, but you were not receiving anything. Now you're not going to do anything like that. You're not going to prove yourself to anyone because you feel like you don't have to prove, right? You're not going to argue with people and make your point because you know that they will not understand, and it's just a waste of time. So you are only going to be with those people who you can who loves you. That's the thing. Who, you know, yeah, with this pick your battles wisely. I'm getting that you're not going to waste your time on the people who will not understand you. Yeah, that's something I'm getting here, because you're choosing yourself. Yeah, or maybe for some of you, you need to work on your throat chakra also. And I feel like you're working. Yeah, Archangel Gabriel is definitely with you guys. I'm getting that. And yeah, you're standing up for yourself. You're not afraid to speak your truth. That's the thing. Maybe people have made you feel like that, that you should do for other people. You should give your 100% to other people. You should work hard. And they never told you to take care of yourself. But now you're understanding that these people were only taking your energy. They were not giving you anything back. They just wanted you for their, you know, sometimes people use us. So I feel like they just used you for their advantage. And now you're understanding that. And now you know who you need to share your ideas with. Maybe there were friends who used to discourage you when you used to share your ideas. They never valued you and they just took from you. But now what is happening in your next phase is that you're not allowing that. You're growing, you're maturing. You're not allowing people to take advantage of you because you're taking care of yourself. Now you are going to do something for yourself. You're making yourself a priority, as I told you, going towards your dream, writing that big bucket list and moving towards it, right? So let's see. Look, we have the rainbows also. So yeah, the skies are clear now. Okay, the storm has passed. Yeah, with this card, that's what I feel like. You were sacrificing for other people. Yeah, you were doing, maybe you were doing something for your siblings, like you were taking care of your siblings, you were working hard, you were taking care of your siblings and your siblings never valued you. They just took advantage of you. Now you're understanding that that you're sacrificing for someone who doesn't appreciate you, okay? They will not give you anything back and now you're taking your stand. So this next phase of your journey is about telling your truth, doing something for yourself, not taking yourself for granted, not allowing people to take advantage of you anymore. And you're not going to sacrifice your dreams for yours, for others anymore because you have done that a lot, right? Yeah, I love that. So what is this next piece of your journey, group number one? Yeah, we have two cards over here. Yeah. Look, we have the tower here. Yeah. A beautiful transformation is coming your way. So something might have happened. You might have gone through a tower moment. Yeah. Someone you valued, someone you trusted might have broken your heart. And now you're understanding how people are taking advantage of you. It can be your parents. It can be your siblings. It can be your friends. And it was like a moment where something like you felt like that the rug is taken from your feet and you just fell and no one was there to support you. You did it alone. Now that this tower moment has made you so strong and now you know who you need to trust. You know, at this time, you know, maybe you have gone through a period where you needed support. No one gave you that support. And some people gave you that support and now you know. Now you know who are your real friends, who will be there for you. And yeah, that's why you're not going to sacrifice anything, your dreams for your friends who are fake, right? You're understanding that. And this tower moment has led you for a beautiful transformation. This has made you strong, right? This has made you aware that how strong you are. Yeah. Now you're not going to allow anyone to take advantage of you. Yeah, with this King of Cups. So I feel like there is someone in your life who has supported you. Now you understand who is there for you. Maybe this person, maybe in the past you didn't value this person, but at your toughest time, this person was there for you. Now you're going to, for some of you, it's like you will be taking guidance from this person and listening to this person and following their guidance. That is something I'm getting. And for others, I feel like this tower moment happened and now you're realizing your own truth. You're balancing your energies. you're feeling peaceful inside. Like this happened, but this is not going to stop you from moving forward. That's what I'm getting here. Now you know your own value. Now you know who you are. Now you know who you need to trust. Now you know that you need to move forward and make your dreams a reality instead of making other people's dreams a reality. Yeah. So for some of you, you are on this spiritual journey. I feel like for some of you have gone through a major awakening also. This can be awakening also, like realizing things from a different perspective, understanding, you know, seeing clearly things. And yes, you're finding the balance in this next phase of your journey. I feel like this tower moment has already happened in your life. You have gone through this chaos. You have understood who is taking advantage of you. Now what I see is like you're going to balance your energies. For some of you, yeah, there is someone who is guiding you. Definitely, I feel like a teacher or a mentor or maybe someone who loves you is guiding you. You're healing yourself. You're finding peace within yourself. Okay, and as I told you, moving forward with your dreams and plans. And we have this ship here. So definitely I see for some of you, yes. Moving away from someone or something that was not good for you guys. So yeah, let's see what else for my group number one. Yeah, honesty and trust. Yeah, you're meeting honest people. In this next phase of your journey, you're going to be with the people who will give you the love that you give to them. I feel like, yeah, I can't always expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. So I feel like you're going to be honest with yourself as well in this next phase of your journey. You're going to be honest and you're going to do things that you want to do in your life. If you don't want to be with someone, you will be honest with them as well. Like, I cannot do that. If someone is asking you to do something that you don't want to do, you will be saying no. You're going to be honest. Maybe you were not honest. You used to take other people's baggages, like other people's work, and you used to not sleep properly because of their work. Now you're not going to do that. As I told you, now your main focus is your own goals, your own desires, and you're fearless now. You're not going to say yes to everything. I feel like that. You're going to be honest with yourself. And I feel like honest people are definitely coming your way. And yeah, trust. I accept that my inner voice will always guide me correctly. So yeah, you're trusting your intuition. What I feel like is like you are only going to be with the people who will give you that energy back. You were with people who used to take your energy, but now you're going to be with people who will give you that love back. The thing that you deserve. You're going to receive the things that you will give. There is balance now. Okay, that's something I'm getting. And trust your intuition. Trust your intuition. Make decision based on your intuition, because your intuition will lead you to the correct destination, correct path. Okay. Yeah. So let's see what else. Yeah, expectation. I feel like in your life you expected something from someone and you didn't get it back. Like with this tower moment happened, you expected someone to give you that love and they didn't give you that. And now in this next phase of your journey, I feel like you're going to only expect from yourself, not from others. You're going to fulfill your own dreams, because you're understanding no one will fulfill my dreams. I have to fulfill everyone. Yeah, you have been taken advantage of. Now you're like letting go of those people, and you're going to make your dreams a reality. So I feel like you're coming back to yourself. You're aligning your chakras. You're meditating. You're grounding your energy. You're trusting your intuition. You're honest with your dreams. You're honest with yourself. I feel like that. Okay. So let's see what else for group number. Maybe some of you recently have gone through a divorce. You might have sacrificed for this person a lot, but this person might have ditched you. But finally, you're over that. You're not expecting anything from that person anymore. Now this new journey is about finding that happiness within yourself, finding that balance within yourself, and making your dreams come true. For some of you, I even feel like that. For this person, you might have not done the things that you wanted to do, but finally now you're doing the things you always wanted to do. So yeah, worth waiting for. Okay, divine timing is at work in your love life. Okay, so for some of you, I'm getting, maybe you want to get into a new relationship. For some of you, is that, so wait, because if you're waiting for that honest relationship, that is coming. Everything will happen at the divine timing, as you're expecting. If you're expecting a relationship, that I want this kind of relationship in my life because I had that bad relationship, if you're visualizing a good relationship, that will happen at the correct timing. Just wait. So yes, definitely there is a good relationship also coming your way, but it will be only given to you at the correct time when you are ready. Because I feel like right now you're not ready. So wait, okay? Yeah, you need to spend some time with yourself. You need to balance your energy. That is something I'm feeling. That is what you're going to do in this next phase of your journey. You have gone through a rough period of your life where you have been sacrificing. Now what I see in this next phase of your journey, you're expecting things from yourself. You're doing things for yourself. You're making yourself a priority. You're balancing your energies. You're finding peace within yourself. So first, it's about self-love, taking care of yourself, doing the things you want, and then getting into a relationship for some of you. So wait, okay? That's what I'm getting for some of you. Okay, so let's see. Wow, yeah, we have Lord Shiva. Yeah, this with the snake, you are shedding the skin. You're not the past person anymore. You're this new person, right? This is like a rebirth for you guys. You have been doing for others. You have been taking care of others. You have been helping others. You have been sacrificing you have been sacrificing your dreams for others. But now you're going to rise up. You're going to shed that skin and you're rising up. Yes, a lot of spiritual progress also with this King of Cups also. I feel like that. You're focusing on your spirituality. You're focusing on your spirituality and through spirituality, you're going to move forward. You know, I feel like spiritual practice will help you a lot in this journey. And Lord Shiva is definitely there for you guys. He's helping you to move forward, to trust more. Maybe you had lost your trust, but he will help you to trust more. Universe is there for you guys. So don't jump into a relationship also. If you're single right now, don't jump into a relationship. Wait, when the timing will come, correct timing will come, you will meet that person. So definitely for some of you, I feel like for some of you, you're not so interested in your relationship also. You're more into the spirituality in this next phase of your journey. For you guys, your dreams are a priority now. You have certain goals and certain ideas in your mind. That is what you need to do. And you're not going to waste your time on the people who don't care for you anymore. You're not going to prove. You don't want to prove anything to anyone. You're just going to focus on yourself. And that is what is happening in this next phase of your journey. Okay? So, but definitely there is a relationship also will come at the correct timing. That's what I'm getting. For some of you, definitely you're waiting. You want a new relationship. So wait. It will come at the correct timing, okay? Because this is a general reading, so there are a lot of messages also. Let's see what the final messages are. Yeah, travel, wow. Yeah, you're moving away from these kind of people who were misusing you, okay? That's something I'm getting here. You're moving away. Long distance communication will open up your life. Exciting experiences for singles and career advancement for others. Yeah, for some of you, yeah, definitely. There is, you have been expecting. So it will come at the correct timing, okay? There is, definitely, if you're single. For others, I feel like your priority will be building up your blocks, like building up your career, focusing on your goals. That's the thing. And definitely spirituality is going to be a part of your life. Chanting mantras, meditation, yeah, and you're building up your intuition also with this third eye and trust here, okay? So That's all I have for group number 3. Take care, guys. Bye-bye. Hello, group number 2. If you have chosen this pirate and sacred traveler oracle cards, let's see what is this next phase of your journey. So I feel like with this pirate, you're going to be becoming very courageous and confident in yourself, in your work. So I feel like if you are learning a new skill, you will be mastering that skill. That's something I'm getting. And if you are in a creative field, you are going to move forward, and slowly but surely you're moving forward. So take small step towards your success. Be focused. Don't lose hope. Don't undervalue yourself. You might underestimate your own power. For others, I even feel like there are more things will come out of you, like more gifts you are going to uncover. Okay, so that's also I'm getting here. But definitely, fortune is going to smile on you in this next phase of your journey. So if you're working hard, your hard work will definitely pay off. Okay, so let's see for group number 2, what is this next phase of your journey. Yeah, embracing enthusiasm. Wow, I feel like with butterflies, maybe for some of you, you want to get a tattoo or something of butterflies, like metamorphosis, like small to big butterflies and all, something like that. So if you want to do that, go ahead and take that, do that, okay? So I feel like maybe you have a tattoo of a butterfly for some of you. Definitely things are moving forward for you guys. As I told you, shout to the heavens with happiness. So you are going to shout to the heavens with happiness. You are going to be happy. You are going to be very, very grateful for all the abundance you are going to manifest in your life. So a lot of happiness. Look at the person. She's so happy. She's so happy. She's so happy to see her own transformation. And that's the thing I see for you guys. You will be looking back and you'll be so happy that how far you have reached. Like you were, for some of you, I see that you will be like thinking about your past, that how you were a cocoon, how you were a caterpillar, now you are such a beautiful butterfly. So you, yes, that's the thing. You are going to be proud of yourself. You will be very, very enthusiastic about your projects, about your creative talents. So for some of you, you might discover something about yourself and it is going to make you so happy, right? So definitely there is a lot of grateful energy I'm getting from you guys. So you'll be very, very grateful for all the small things that you're getting in your life, because you're going to be very happy. You will be happy by your success. That's something I'm feeling, group number 2. Yes, you are going to be happy the way things are moving forward. Okay, that's what I'm getting here. So definitely there is leveling up, okay? For some of you, it can be you will get a relationship like a relationship progress, and you will be so happy about that. Or for some of you, in your career, you will be progressing. Maybe it's a personal role that is progressing, so you'll be very happy. Or maybe it's like your confidence, inner self, inner transformation, and you'll be very proud of that. Spiritual transformation, and you'll be very proud of that. So yeah, let's see. What is this next phase of your journey, group number 2? Look, emerge. Yes, for some of you, you are going to be in the spotlight. People are going to notice you for who you are. So maybe you have been working on something, on your creative abilities or your talents, and finally people are noticing you. Okay, maybe you do dance videos. Finally, your dance videos are getting, people are noticing it, people are recognizing it. So yeah, center stage, coming in the spotlight, you're emerging. Like you were in this box, this caterpillar, now you're becoming that beautiful butterfly, and you will be so happy. You are going to shine that light by seeing your videos or by seeing your dance, by seeing your talent. People will feel so happy. So yeah, your content will make people happy, and you will be so happy because they are happy. Like yeah, you're going to be proud of yourself. That's what I'm getting here. For some of you, dancing also I'm hearing. Maybe you're dancers. So yes, that is, people will love it. Yeah. So yes, people are going to notice your recognition is coming your way. That's what is happening in this next phase of your journey. So let's see what else for group number 2. What is this next phase of your journey, group number 2? Next phase of your journey, group number 2. Oh, there is a little bit of stress. Like, I feel like the thing that will come in between your success is you, your stress, your overthinking. So you need to manage that through meditation, or by going out in nature through music. So yeah, you are the one who is doubting yourself. No one else will doubt you, but you will doubt yourself. So yeah, there is this Nine of Swords energy. Or maybe right now you're thinking, you're stressing, oh, what if this happens? What if I don't succeed? I'm starting this. I have quit my job for doing this thing. Will this pan out? Like, you're stressing a lot. Don't stress. Keep on moving forward, because this next phase of journey, don't take the stress with you. But I feel like this pile is a little bit of overthinkers. Even you have a lot of talents, even you're gifted, you doubt yourself, you doubt your talents. You're a perfectionist also, for some of you, I feel like that. So let go of that. Maybe if you have, for some of you, if you want to, if you want to film a video, like a dance video, you stress about it the day before and you cannot have sleep because you are so much stressing about it. So don't stress. Like, that is the thing, you need to work on it, okay? Through meditation, through yoga, for some of you going out in nature, listening to good music, okay? Or maybe before night, avoid social media. Avoid social media, I'm getting, like, don't compare yourself to other people. Don't do that, because you're so much more than that. Group number two, you're different, you're unique, so accept that. Don't compare yourself to other people. Different people will do it differently. You do it in your way, in your style. Okay, that was going to, when you do it in your style, that will come out beautifully. And that is the thing people will get attracted to. So don't try to copy anyone. Okay? For group number two, what is this next phase of your journey? Again, look, Eight of Swords energy and Nine of Swords energy. You are the one who is coming in between your path, your stress. You're feeling like blocked. So that is what you need to work on. In this, maybe right now also, maybe for some of you, this is the energy right now where you're feeling stuck, you're not believing in your own power, in your own talent. So that is what you need to work on, guys. With this Nine and Eight of Swords, I'm getting, look guys, we got the Six of Wands. Yeah, so you are going to win. As I told you, I was talking about that recognition, fame. For some of you, you want that. And understand, you are the magician. You have the power. You have the resources. You have the talent. Everything is within you. You can create whatever you want to create. The only thing that will come in between is your own stress. You are going to put in yours. You are going to doubt yourself. That is the only blockage here. And as I told you, you are the one who is undervaluing yourself. You are the one who is doubting you. Did I say that correctly? Like, you are the one, you are doubting yourself. That's the thing. And that's the biggest blockage. So that is what you need to work on. No one else can come in between your success. The person that will come is you, your thoughts, your negative beliefs, your stress. That is what you need to let go of. Okay? So you can, with this magician card, you're very powerful manifestors. You can create your success. But at the same time, you can create your own failure also through stress and with this Eight of Swords energy. So yeah, that's something I'm getting here. So let's see what else. There was no charge on my phone. So let's see what else. What is this next phase of your journey for group number two? What is this next phase of your journey? Oh yeah, look. Look, Nine of Swords and Eight of Swords, and we have failure. So I feel like for some of you, you have failed in the past, and now you're fearing failure again. That's the thing, and that's why you have a lot of stress. So maybe you're doing something again. It's like giving an exam again. Did I tell you about that exam? I feel like I told, like, fear of failure. Oh, I did this thing in the past. What if I get, what if I fail again, right? So that's why there is a lot of stress and you're putting yourself in a mental cage. So it was just not the correct timing at that time. So yeah, so now you have this opportunity, make use of it. Don't let this fear come in between. I understand that a mistake is only an opportunity to learn. So yeah, you have learned a lot of lessons, learn from your mistakes. Don't repeat those mistakes, and you are going to thrive. You are going to get the success. You are going to pass that examination. So don't let this fear come in between. So as I told you, the thing that will come in between your success is you. Your mentality, your negative beliefs, your thoughts. That is what you need to change, group number two. Okay, let's see what else for group number two. What is this next phase of your journey? For some of you, it's like even like you tried to lose weight, but it didn't happen. Now you're trying again and you're so fearful that, no, what if I don't, I'm just doing this again. What if I don't succeed? Like, a lot of thinking is going on, a lot of negative thinking. So you need to work on that, guys. Wealthy man. Okay, maybe for some of you, you might receive an opportunity from someone. Like if you are, it's just an example, like if you are a person who is making content, maybe there will be someone who will come and sponsor your content. Okay, they will like your work and they will make give you that opportunity. So definitely there is an opportunity to make more money that is coming your way. So this next phase of your journey, I told you, this fortune is going to smile on you, right? And with this wealthy man, I'm also getting there is someone around you who is very good at finances, managing finances. So they might help you with your finances. They will tell you where to invest, how to invest. So I feel like that also. Maybe for some of you in the past, you invested your money in some place, and maybe that's why you're worried about your money situation also. So there is definitely help coming your way. Okay, definitely with this labor card, I'm seeing that your hard work is definitely going to pay off. So don't worry, use the second chance and don't let the fear of failure come in between. Okay, so that's the thing you need to work on. Okay, let's see what else. You need to embrace more playful energy, guys. Like, do some fun activities with your friends. Whenever you're feeling stressed, don't keep on stressing. Instead, do something, some fun activities, the activities that you love. Okay, because this next phase of your journey, there is a lot of success, there is a lot of abundance coming your way. So I even feel like even if you reach a goal, you will be feeling very stressed about your next goal. So instead of celebrating that success, you will be fearing about your next stage. So next step, right? So don't do that. Enjoy your wins, small wins. Okay, group number two. So let's see. Your foundation is strong. That's what I'm getting with this stuff. You know, your foundation is strong. Your foundation is not something that will fall apart easily. It's very strong. So believe in yourself. Yeah, sometimes we make mistakes. Sometimes we are not going to produce the things that are perfect. Sometimes people will criticize. It's okay. We grow, we learn. Okay? So be kind. Be kind to yourself. I feel like this spider is kind to others, but sometimes you're not kind to yourself. You need to be more kinder to yourself. Oh, romantic feelings. Codependency. I feel like with this codependency, you know, I feel like you're letting go of that. Maybe if you're in a codependent relationship, if you are like in a codependent relationship with your spouse, maybe you're financially, you are very dependent on your spouse. I feel like you're finding your financial independence. And for others, it's like maybe you're dependent upon your parents. You're finding your independence there also. Financial independence definitely is happening. And for others, if you have been addicted to something, for some of you, it's like with this codependency, I'm feeling like you're stressed. Stress issues are also going to be released. Maybe you need to work on that. And definitely if you're addicted to something, you need to work on that also. Maybe whenever you're emotional, you eat a lot of ice cream. Maybe you need to change that behavior. Maybe you smoke a lot. Whenever you're stressed, you smoke a lot. It's not good. Okay? Right? So work on that. Romantic feelings. Your feelings are real and worth exploring. For some of you, definitely you have a crush on someone. You want to, maybe this is a person who is financially well and who has a name, so you have certain feeling for this person, but you are so worried that this person might reject you because in the past you might have got rejected, or you feel like that you're not worthy enough for this person's love. So that is the problem. You're undervaluing yourself. Be confident, be courageous. And if you have certain feelings for someone, say it out, because this life, sometimes it's okay. Sometimes it's okay to say the things that you feel, right? Even though the outcome is not in your favor, it's okay. So don't keep it to your heart. Like convey your message. That is also I'm getting. Be strong, be courageous. Maybe for some of you, you always keep it to your heart. You never share your feelings. You always keep it to your heart. Maybe it's time to say it out. Don't be afraid and say it out, right? Maybe you might get a positive result. So hope for that positive result and go for it, right? But definitely, with this, your feelings are real and worth exploring. That means, yes, this might become something. This relationship might progress. And for some of you, for others, I feel like if you're in a committed relationship, your most focus will be your career. In some way, I feel like that your own personal goals that you will be moving forward with. Okay. Yeah. And I even feel like that for this pile, I feel like your spouse will move forward in their career as well. This is a message like finances, their finances will also grow. They might get an opportunity. They might get a promotion or an opportunity that will make their finances very good. Okay. So that's something else I'm getting in this next phase of your journey. Yeah. So let's see. For group number two. For some of you, I even feel like that, you know, if you are in a relationship where you're seeing a lot of red flags, maybe it's time to let go of that person. Maybe with this Nine of Swords and Eight of Swords energy, there you are with someone. And whenever you're with this person, you stress about this person, or maybe they try to pull you down in a way. If that is the case, don't ignore the red flags and get out of it. Okay, yeah, that's something I'm getting here. Yeah, maybe for some of you, you are codependent because of finances or something like that. You are going to find your own independence and you will be out of this thing. Okay, so yeah, that's something I'm getting here. Yeah, wow, charity. Yeah, your prayers are coming true, guys. You have been wishing for something. You have been praying for something. You have been opening up your heart and you have been praying. You have been chanting. You have been meditating. Like for some of you, there is fear, but then too, you have been praying a lot. I feel like that, and your prayers will come true. Okay, that is something I'm getting here. And your work, I feel like the work you're doing, the work is moving very slowly. There is slow progress, but the work you're doing is helping a lot of people. Like your dance, if you're dancers, your dance is like giving a lot of happiness to other people. If you're teachers, your teaching is giving a lot of information to other people. So you're doing the good work right now. So maybe the progress is slow. Maybe the finances that you want, is you didn't get it right now, but it will come. You will be able to free yourself from all the codependent relationship habits that are not good for you guys. So definitely your wishes are coming true. You are making steady progress. It's slow progress, but steady progress. And you are going to get that rewards, that recognition that you deserve. Okay? And you deserve more love. Yeah? And Divine is telling you deserve more love. I'm getting like you deserve more love and you're going to get that. You're not going to be in a relationship where you will feel uncomfortable all the time, or where you feel in a mental prison. If you're not feeling good with that person, if you're feeling like always uncomfortable with that person, it's a red flag. So get out of that. Let go of that person. I'm getting that also. I feel like you will be letting go of that person. In this next phase of your journey, you're going to let go of a lot of things that are troubling you. Maybe it can be inside thing that is troubling you, some inside traumas that you have, like past traumas, that is also I feel like you are letting go of. A lot of inner child healing is also I'm feeling for you guys. So communication, I'm getting like communicate your truth. If you feel like you need to share your feelings with someone, like if you like someone, go out and say that. Don't be worried about the outcome. Don't be worried about the result. Instead, enjoy the journey. Like maybe for many of you in this pile, I feel like you always are so stressed about the outcome. Rather than enjoying the journey, you are just worried about the result. So instead of worrying about the result, instead of worrying about the outcome, all you need to do is to enjoy the journey, be more positive, pray, because your prayers are heard. Your angels are hearing your prayers. It's you know, your intentions, the manifestations you're doing, it's going to come true for you guys. That's something I'm getting. Yeah. Look, we have cosmic gateway. Your thoughts are magnetic and powerful. Miraculous changes are occurring. With this, your thoughts are magnetic and powerful. So remember, your thoughts are magnetic and powerful. So with this nine of swords and eight of swords, if your thoughts are negative, it can be manifested. Okay, it will also manifest. So that is what you need to work on. Group number two, that is advice from your spirit guides. When you're going to, you know, you're in your next phase of your journey, don't take that negative attitude. Okay, maybe if you try something new, you will be so afraid of the failure. Instead, focus on the positivity. That is something I'm getting here. So let's see what are the final messages for group number two. Yeah, wow, major life change. The time is right for major life changes. So definitely things are changing for you guys. As I told you, there is definitely abundance coming your way. Financial growth I'm seeing for you guys. Yeah. As a new lifestyle or new location brings great joy and a trouble-free existence. So yeah, trouble-free. So you need to free yourself from your own overthinking. That is something you need to work on, guys. Meditation, prayers, chanting, doing fun activities, that is going to help you. But definitely things are going to change for you guys. You're going to get that success, that lifestyle you always dreamt of, that recognition that you want, that good relationship you want. Getting out of this, for some of you, you always want to get out of a relationship. You're getting out of it. So don't be afraid of failures anymore, because you will win this time. You're going to win. So believe. But if you don't believe in yourself, if you stress all the time, if you put your energy into this negative thinking, that can also come true. So I'm just going to leave you with this. Bye-bye. Take care, group number two. Hello, group number three. If you have chosen this sodalite crystal, let's see what is your message. What is this next phase of your journey? Okay. So if you have chosen the wisdom of the oracle cards, so let's see what is this next phase of your journey. For group number three, what is this next phase of the journey? I'm hearing go for it. Go for it. Listen to your heart and go for it. For some of you, I feel like there is a good opportunity coming your way. So go for it. Yeah. Message in a bottle. So yeah, definitely a good opportunity, a message, a call you might receive. So go for it. Or maybe it can be a love offer or it can be a job offer. Just go for it. Okay, because this will give you a lot of happiness and success. And I even feel like you're healing a lot of your past issues. You're overcoming your difficulties and you're very sharp. You're becoming a very good decision maker. Like, you know when, what step to take, when to take. Yeah, your intuitive abilities are on point, and now you listen to your intuition more than anything. In this next phase of your journey, you are going to do that. You're going to be very peaceful also, I feel like. So definitely, there is a new offer coming your way that is going to change your life. And this new, definitely a new offer, a love offer, a new job offer, or maybe a sign from the universe, a message from the universe, like clarity, getting your clarity, what you need to do. And that's why spirit was telling, go for it. Take that chance, take that leap of faith, move forward, because that will give you a lot of success. So let's see what else for group number three. What is this next phase of their journey? Oh wow, look, new beginning. Yeah, definitely a new offer, a love offer. You might receive a phone call, maybe some people want to work with you. So go for it. That will be very, very, very good for you guys. You will feel very happy. For some of you, it can be like you are receiving a message that you are pregnant. Yeah, with this child, maybe you're becoming mothers or you're already pregnant. So then this next phase of your journey, you will become mother. For some of you, it can be a creative idea that will be very successful. And look at the feathers. With these feathers, I feel like for some of you, you are building a connection with your angels. That can be a new start as well. Like you're building up your intuition, you're listening to your intuition more. So that is also the thing. And you're very safe. You're in the safe hands. Okay, so whatever this opportunity is, take that opportunity because you are going to be in the safe hands. Yeah. So yeah, things are going to definitely change for you guys. This new start, this new cycle will give you a lot of happiness. So let's see what else is for my group number three. This next phase of your journey, I'm getting a baby girl for some of you. Okay, like if you're pregnant, if you're three of cups. Wow. So for some of you, it's like a new friendship. Maybe your friend is calling you, and maybe a childhood friend is calling you, and you are connecting with them again. So socializing, more fun events. Maybe you're getting a call to attend a social event. Where you might meet a new friend and they might give you a good opportunity to work with them. So something like that. Maybe you will be collaborating with your friends, or maybe you will meet some stranger and they will become your friends and you might be working together with them. So definitely don't ignore an invitation, a social invitation if you get, because that will be very beneficial for you guys and that will lead to a new beginning. For some of you, that the social event you might meet your partner, okay, maybe a love partner. So that is also I'm getting. That's the thing. So definitely there is a friendship. In this next phase of your journey, you're going to meet new people who will become your friends. And this is a new, for some of you, this might be new friendship because we have a new beginning and three of cups. So definitely you are finding your soul tribe in this next phase of your journey, okay? So maybe I'm getting like people with different cultures, different backgrounds. That's something I'm getting here. Yeah, so go to that workshop, go to that seminar, because there you might find someone. That's something I'm getting here. So let's see what is the message for group number three for the next phase of the journey. Wow, yeah, death card. Yeah, rebirth. It's like ending of a cycle, definitely, because we are talking about next phase of your journey. So definitely there is this aspect where you're ending, letting go of the things that was not serving you, maybe letting go of toxic friendship, and now you are making new friends, letting go of a toxic job, I feel like the job you will get the co-workers will become your friends. That is also I'm getting, like the work place will be so calm and peaceful where your co-workers will be like family. For some of you, you are getting that thing, okay? So something about that. Maybe for some of you, you are learning something about astrology, or you want to learn about that. Maybe you're going there to that thing. Go ahead, that will give you a lot of happiness. But definitely your different cultures, different people with the different cultures are coming together and making something extraordinary. So that's something I'm getting. And we have this lavender. Maybe you're into herbs and all. Maybe you will collaborate with someone and you will make a very good thing. I don't know, but definitely that's thing. Maybe you'll start a project and that will be very successful. So we have death and rebirth, definitely letting go of toxic relationship, letting go. It's a new birth. You're feeling new beginning. Like for some of you, moving to a new place, maybe you'll get a new job somewhere else. Go for it. Take that opportunity because this is going to give you this is the place, this thing will like when you move to a new place, you will meet people who are like you, like your soul tribe. That's something I'm getting here. Yeah. And we have number two here. 2, then we have 3, and then we have 4. So definitely you're leveling up. And I'm even getting that you're finding your inner balance. Yeah, I'm getting like you're going to be very, very balanced. And for some of you, you might meet a new teacher in this next phase of a journey who will guide you, who will help you to find that inner balance, inner peace. Okay, that is something I'm getting. Yeah, imagination. Okay, for some of you, I feel like you are doing a lot of visualization right now. You have certain goals in your mind, you're visualizing, you're writing the list. If you're doing that, I feel like that imagination is going to come true. Yeah, your wishes are going to come true for some of you. And for others, it's like you will be using your imagination for your work. Okay, that is something. Maybe you will be collaborating with someone and you will be creating a kid's book together, or maybe you will be doing some DIY project together, and that needs your imagination. So your imagination, you're going to your daydream, you'll be daydreaming a lot. I'm getting like, yeah, for some of you, if you're daydreaming right now, I feel like your daydreams are coming true. For others, it's like imagine. Yes, a lot of creativity is there. Take that creative ideas, work on that ideas, because that ideas will give you a lot of happiness. I embrace and nourish the creative aspect of my mind. So you're very creative souls. So a lot of good things are going to come out of you. And you are going to meet the soul tribe who will love your ideas. And together you will make something extraordinary. So yeah, definitely there is a project, new project. New project for some of you, this new beginning can be a new project, and your imagination will make that project successful. Okay, so that's something I'm getting here. So let's see for group number 3, what is this next phase of your journey? So for some of you, you might receive this offer. Take this offer, because this offer will give you a lot of happiness. You know, your project will be successful as well. You will find friends. That's something I'm getting here. Yeah, look, confirmation message. Definitely a very, very good news is coming your way, offer. For some of you, this can be a love offer also, but this is something you have been imagining. You have been imagining about this. You have been visualizing about it, and that is going to come true for you guys in this next phase of your journey. Okay, for some of you, this is related to your occupation. This is something that you want. You are creative. Maybe you are dressmakers, or you do that. You are very creative. So you are going to be collaborating with someone who have the same passion, and you're going to make something extraordinary, as I told you, definitely. So let's see, what is this next phase of your journey? Look, we have 2, we have 3, we have 4, we have 6 here, and we have 7. Only the number missing is like 5. So yeah, definitely there is progress. Okay. Flirt, extend your light-hearted energy to others. So definitely there is going to be people who will you will share a lot of good time with. I'm getting with this with your friends. You will have a lot of light-hearted time, making fun of each other, teasing each other, enjoying that time, like waking up till 3 o'clock and talking about things like this. These people are going to understand you. You know, maybe you don't have good friends, and finally you are finding those good friends. For others, it can be like this message is from your romantic partner, and you will be flirting with them. You will be talking to them late at night, enjoying things. Enjoying time together. That is something I'm getting. For some of you, have been imagining about a relationship. If you're manifesting that, that is happening for you guys. So yeah, definitely a lot of light-hearted energy, a lot of fun energy, laughing together. Or maybe for some of you, while doing this project, you will meet this person and you will spend good time together. But definitely this is like fun energy. You will be enjoying this project a lot. You will be happy doing this project. Oh wow, look, stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. So right now I feel like you're imagining about something. You want a good partner, you want to you're ready for a relationship, so you're imagining that. So right now keep on imagining, because that is happening for you guys, okay? Yeah, definitely in the back of the deck we have this new love. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. So if you have a crush on someone, if you want that person, like if you're imagining, I feel like that person might message you and you will be very happy. So definitely a new relationship is happening for some of you in this next first phase of your journey. Something that you have been imagining is coming true. For others, it's about your career, finding the soul tribe. Yeah. So let's see what else. Oh wow, we have Archangel Michael. Wow, maybe you pray to him, maybe he is your spirit guide, maybe you believe in him, but definitely Archangel Michael is there for you, guiding you, trusting heaven. You are safe. Angels stand close. Surrender your concerns and allow a miracle to occur. Interestingly, I told you about the feathers in this card, right? Your angels are, maybe you're trying to make that connection with your angels. So definitely you have a connection with Archangel Michael. He is helping you to cut the cords from the past, to let go of the things that is not serving you, to let go of the past relationship that you are holding on to. So yeah, definitely there is going to be a lot of release that is happening. You're releasing old patterns. Maybe there was a cycle where your relationship, you know, for some of you, I feel like you were having the same experiences in your relationship. Finally, things are the pattern, the cycle is ending, okay? So now this new person who is coming will be different. So yeah, that's something I'm getting. So be optimistic about that. So maybe for some of you, you might get pessimistic about your relationship, you know, when you're flirting with this person, or when you're knowing this person, you because of your past beliefs, past relationship, there might be a little bit of worry from your part. So let go of that. Call upon Archangel Michael. He is definitely protecting you. And yeah, that's something I'm getting here. And I'm hearing red flags. If you see some red flags, if this person is not correct for you guys, you will see the red flags and you will let them go. So definitely there is a lot of protection. You're in safe hands, as I told you here. Archangel Michael is definitely protecting you in this next phase of your journey. Okay, so call upon him. So let's what are the last cards for you guys? What is the message? What is this next phase for group number 3, next phase of the journey? We have intuition. Trust your intuition. It's a great time to learn a new skill, change careers, or invest money, or maybe you will be inventing something. As I told you, something extraordinary is going to come out from you, like you will be collaborating with someone and something extraordinary you're going to make. So trust your intuition. In this case, you know, when you get that offer, you will know it in your heart that I need to take action. So yeah, for some of you, you have been imagining about it and that's coming true. Definitely your visualization skills are on point. So keep on visualizing. Don't give up. Okay, believe in it. Be optimistic about it, because definitely there is as I told you, a new beginning in your career where you will be collaborating with someone. And maybe you're collaborating with someone, and there you will be able to invest money, and things are looking good for your career and your finances. And definitely your love life is also going to blossom for some of you if you are visualizing that. If you want a new relationship, that is also happening. Okay, so yeah, that's it for group number 3. Hope you like the reading. I will see you soon. Bye bye, take care.